This project is a huge project for LSU, but it's a huge project for this state and the impact that it's going to have. And what I can say is, on behalf of the LSU administration, we are 110% behind this project. This is wonderful. And this project, putting it together, is not so much about the people who are up here, it is about you. Each one of you is going to have a hand in putting this project together.
I just want to make one point before I introduce your next speaker. Remember, this university, this great university's middle word is Louisiana State University. This institution exists to serve the citizens of the state and today's world beyond those borders. There is not a question that our state is in desperate need of engineers and engineering as we look to the economic developments that are going to occur in the next few years. We have to play a role in the education, the training, the service, and the experience in the engineering arena as we prepare for the Louisiana of tomorrow.
Today's economy needs engineers as much as it ever did. And in fact, as Dean Kubek presented, getting from 700 to 1,000 engineers from one university is quite monumental, because the nation only produces 90,000 engineers currently. So having 1,000 engineers come from one university tells the significance of the role this university not only plays now, but can play in the future. Thanks to this new facility, but more importantly, thanks to the commitment that this university has had to engineering. So let us help you succeed in life. Let us help you succeed with this educational endeavor. And we're here to make sure that you have the best facilities possible to learn and to promote in the engineering field for decades to come.
It's going to take LSU engineering to the next level, and I think we'll help it gain the peer recognition that it truly deserves. I'm a firm believer that this project is kind of a, if you build it, they will come type of project, and that's what's going to lift this college up, and I really think it's probably the most important project in the history of the College of Engineering. Now it gives me great pleasure to introduce my co-chair, Phyllis Taylor, to continue our discussion. Phyllis and Patrick were quite a team in the oil and gas industry, and in their support of LSU and students assisting them in pursuing an engineering education. Phyllis continues in business and philanthropic activities in her own right, and in the legacy of Pat as well. And as I think, as most of you know, the university honored the Taylors in 2007 by naming this hall after Patrick. So with that, Phyllis, turn the program to you.
When I sat on this podium back in 2007, very similar to this one, so that we could unveil this plaque that you see right before you and the sign that's behind you, which says Patrick F. Taylor Hall, I had two conflicting emotions, pride and humility. Pride, because I realized that what my husband had accomplished as a student of LSU and a graduate in petroleum engineering, and what he had accomplished in his field of study and in his career, and what he had accomplished in education by spearheading what has now become the TOPS program, that would now be recognized in a perpetual manner made me very proud indeed. And yet at the same time, I felt very humbled that individuals, not myself, had worked so hard to accomplish this, and that the Board of Supervisors for LSU had unanimously approved that this building be named for him. Today, I have one bone to pick with Harry. He says, build it and it will come, and you will come. I don't agree with that. I believe that the engineers of tomorrow are already here and knocking at the doors to come in. And that is why we need to expand and refurbish this building, because there are more out there that want to be here, and we don't have the faculty space or the student classroom space to bring them here and teach them as we need to do. So this is one of the reasons I'm enthusiastic about this program. So once again, pride and humility. Pride because I know all of you that are students of the College of Engineering and all of those in the future will follow in the footsteps of my husband, whether your degree is in petroleum engineering or in some other field of engineering, to contribute not only to your own financial well-being, but also to the success of our nation and our state. And humility, because I stand here as a representative of my husband, who would in fact be so pleased to be able to announce what I can announce to you today. So I make a commitment on his behalf and in his honor for the renovation of this building, the Patrick F. Taylor Hall, of $15 million. To join me, I realize that there aren't many that can contribute to that level, but whatever you contribute, that is your statement publicly to the well-being and the future of our students, our state, and our nation. So please join me in making this project a reality. Thank you.
Mrs. Taylor, on behalf of our students, our faculty, our staff, the alumni, and the generations on the way, this amazing gift is going to jumpstart this project and jumpstart it in a way that will push it to fruition much, much more quickly. And as the saying goes, from the generations of the past, we greet the generations of the future. This wonderful, wonderful gift is going to push this through and push us through to make sure this project comes to fruition through the year of 2014. So on behalf of all of us, this entire LSU family, President Jenkins, and so many of us, thank you very much from all of us. Thank you, Mrs. Taylor.